Hello all, this is Universal Group of Institutions, Bangalore. Be the change that you wish to see in the world, said Mahatma Gandhi. We all know about Mahatma Gandhi, right? Who doesn't know? But do you know what ignited the spark of his activism? So Mahatma Gandhi, let's first learn about him. So he was born in Porbandar, Gujarat. So maybe this is something we've been studying since our lower classes, and was educated in England. He began his journey as a legal counsel in South Africa in the year 1893. It was there that a pivotal moment occurred. Gandhi was thrown off a train despite holding a first-class ticket simply because he was an Indian. This incident became a turning point in his life, driving him to stand up against racial discrimination and class oppression. Let's now look at his fight for justice in South Africa. So let us see how Gandhiji played an important role in South Africa's justice as well. So in response to the discrimination that he had faced in the train, Gandhi founded the Natal Indian Congress. This was in the year 1894, and he did this to combat injustice. He later led the first Satyagraha campaign in 1906, opposing the Transvaal Asiatic Ordinance and introducing the world to his philosophy of non-violent resistance. A significant supporter of Gandhi during this time was Dada Abdullah, who played a fatherly role in Gandhi's life and supported him in the South African Satyagraha movement. Gandhi's 21 years in South Africa shaped his core beliefs in Ahimsa. So what is Ahimsa? Ahimsa means non-violence as well as equality. So all these principles that would later define his work, and it did define his work. Do you know why 2nd October holds such a great significance? Why is it that we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti? Why is it declared as a national government holiday? On 2nd October, we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti in India. But remember, it's just not confined to India. It's also observed and celebrated globally. And it's considered to be the International Day of Non-Violence internationally. Gandhi's teachings of non-violence, truth, it's still up till today, continues to inspire people all around the world. And that's why Gandhi Jayanti has a significant role in the entire universe. Now let's explore Gandhi's major contributions to India's independence movement. So we have learned about how he played a role in South Africa's justice. Now we'll see how he's played a role in the India's independence movement. So Gandhiji played a crucial role in India's freedom struggle, leading iconic movements like the non-cooperation movement of the year 1920, Dandi March of the year 1930, and the Quit India movement of the year 1942. These non-violent campaigns united millions and millions of Indians in their fight against British rule, ultimately leading to India's independence in the year 1947. But Gandhi's vision went far beyond just political freedom, didn't it? Don't you all agree with me? So definitely, absolutely, Gandhi's vision was not just political liberation, it was way beyond that. He was a strong advocate for social justice, rural development, empowerment of marginalized communities. He worked tirelessly for Hindu-Muslim unity, women's rights, and the abolition of untouchability. Gandhi believed that true freedom could only be achieved if each and every section of the society would be treated with dignity as well as equality. Now, do we know who Gandhi's political guru was? It was Gopal Krishna Gokhale, who profoundly influenced Gandhi's views on governance and reform. In 1915, Rabindranath Tagore bestowed upon him the title Mahatma. So what does Mahatma mean? It means great soul. Later, it was Subhash Chandra Bose who lovingly started calling him as Bapu. And Bapu means father. That's why he's called as a father of our nation. And that recognizes, so why was he called as Bapu? Why was he called as a father? Because he was trying to recognize Gandhi's role as a spiritual leader of India's independent movement. Well, that's all for now. Thank you, stay tuned.